I had a child who died. My wife sent me two cables. You see, she meant to break the thing gently. I got the first one in the morning. It read, Catherine died this afternoon. No pain. I got the second one at lunchtime. It read, Catherine seriously ill. Doctor has hope.
How terrible for you.
No, the terrible thing was that when I got the second telegram, I was so muddled in my head that I thought she must still be alive. And for a moment I was disappointed. And that was the terrible thing. I thought, now the anxiety begins. And the pain.
That's a pitiful thought, don't you think? A man who became a monk with most of his life gone. Kneeling in church and staring at the altar and knowing that there's nothing on the altar but wafers of communion bread. Not God, just pieces of bread. I suppose you'd call it a depression, I call it hell, an empty state.
I shall quickly outline the etiology of alcoholism, how the disease begins. First, the weight of the world settles on you. A heavy depression. In the distance, you see a way out. A promising little exit. Small and round. About the right size to fit a cork.
Clumsy, drunken fool.
Who says I'm drunk? It's an accident.
What happens gradually is that the alcohol breaks down the fatty tissue between the cells. And one cell that had character blends into another that hasn't. It happens so slowly you don't even know it's going on. And you like it while it's happening, that's the worst of it. You'll love it. It's the exhilarating process of decay.
I know you're not happy either. Without me, you'll have peace.
You can't give me peace.
Mr. Hadlock's bought the picture I did of you.
Wants a picture of me on his wall.
Darling, this isn't the way.
See here, Mr. Addock.
Hadlock.
It's me you're buying in that picture. Here's the real thing. £20 worth of sweat here. Go on, feel it.
Walter. You clumsy, drunken lout. The house is filthy with you.
Get out!
If I go away, you will have peace.
You've no conception of what peace means.
You don't know. It isn't what I've done that torments me. It's the reason. It's the madness that drove me to it.
You have been possessed of a devil.
I've torn my life to pieces!
No, you don't.
Let me go! Let me out!
Justify yourself!
Take too long. I would have to begin with arguments to God.
Why must you act like that?
I'm not love, dear, because I'm love. So I act love.
What am I to do with you? What?
But can't you trust that the suffering won't be too great?
No. I have no such trust.